Now there is another result, equation of the resultant. Here we have G. G is the moment of all the coplanar forces about the origin acting on a rigid body. Means the rigid body is experiencing forces P1, P2, P3, etc. So in our earlier article we have shown that the moment G will be summation Y1 X1 minus X1 Y1. Suppose we have a point Q Xi Eta, the moment of the force P1 whose resolved part is X1 and Y1. So moment of the force P1 about this point Q is given as Y1 into X1 minus Xi minus X1 into Y1 minus Eta. Since Xi Eta is a point, so this will be equal to Y1 X1 minus X1 Y1 minus this Y1 Xi and plus this X1 Eta. Okay. Therefore, the total moment G dash of all the forces about the point Q is given as, we will need to take summations or the same expression for other forces P1, P2, P3, etc. All of them are added. So this G1, G dash is equal to summation over this one minus summation over this one plus summation over this one. This Xi is a constant, so this is Xi summation Y1, this Eta is constant, Eta into summation X1. So this is our earlier G minus Xi Ry plus Eta Rx. Therefore, since the point Q, suppose the point Q lies on the resultant, so in this case, this G dash will be 0 since it is the resultant. It is lying on the point Q lies on the resultant. Therefore, it is 0. It means G minus Xi Ry plus Eta Rx is equal to 0. This is the line of action of the resultant. If you replace this Xi and Eta by XY, then we obtain the line of action of the resultant as G minus X Ry plus Y Rx is equal to 0. This is our equation of the resultant. This is the equation of the resultant.